Business Tonight investors have heaved a sigh of relief over news that China's property giant Evergrande Group has agreed on a plan to repay interest on one of its key bonds. In doing so, the debt-laden company has, for now, avoided a default, which many had feared would derail the world's second-largest economy and spark a financial crisis. But what lies ahead? Olivia Seong reports.
All eyes have been on Evergrande Group's interest payments due Thursday, seen as an indicator of the true extent of the Chinese developer's money woes. On Wednesday, Hengda Real Estate Group announced it would make the coupon payment on its Shenzhen-traded bond on time. This estimated at about $36 million. While there has been no word on whether the $83.5 million in interest for an offshore bond will be paid out, this has brought some reassurance to nervous investors and global markets. The developer had already missed interest payments due earlier this week to two of its largest bank creditors. Now, the Evergrande Group is China's second largest property developer with a presence in more than 280 cities, like here in the north in Beijing, while it's headquartered in the south in Shenzhen. The group employs 200,000 people and claims to indirectly generate 3.8 million Chinese jobs. According to the company's report, its total assets are the equivalent of around 2.2% of China's GDP. There have been protests seen by investors and suppliers demanding payment, as the group has said it's facing unprecedented challenges with debt amounting to over $300 billion.
Evergrande Group, the Evergrande Group, has gross debt of something like $300 billion. So this that's an enormous amount. If it collapses, certainly it will have a major shockwave in the financial sector in China. Luckily, most of the debt of the Evergrande Group are held by Chinese nationals, so very few by overseas foreign entities. So the shockwave will be mostly felt in China. But still, because of this enormous amount, people fear that any shockwave in the financial sector in China could affect global financial markets.
Chinese regulators have yet to say what they might do about the Evergrande Group, although Chinese media have added that Evergrande should not rely on a government bailout. The S&P ratings agency has suggested that authorities would likely intervene only if they considered any large-scale fallout was likely to happen. That's because any official resolution is expected to involve losses for banks and bondholders. Olivia Seong, CNA, Beijing.
Well, despite assurance of an on-time coupon payment, investors are still playing a guessing game about whether China Evergrande will actually make good on its promises to pay up. The vagueness of the announcement has raised a number of questions. In a statement to the Shenzhen Stock Exchange, Hengda Real Estate Group said it had resolved the domestic bond payments through negotiations. It didn't specify how much interest would be paid, when it would be paid, or even if it would actually be paid. Now, this is raising speculation that Evergrande struck a deal with bondholders to postpone interest payments without having to label the move a default. It could also be that authorities behind the scenes are orchestrating negotiations with domestic investors to buy time. But offshore bondholders will be more difficult to manage. Now, of Evergrande's more than $300 billion of liabilities, it has $19.2 billion in outstanding offshore notes and about $8 billion in local securities. It also owes $670 million in interest through the end of this year. The sheer magnitude of its debt total load, it little wonder that concern about Evergrande's future persists. Now, Evergrande's temporary assurance over its domestic bond has injected some calm into the markets. The Shanghai Composite managed to pull ahead by 0.4% today. The China Central Bank pumped an additional $19 billion into the banking system. Analysts say another move by the PBOC to soothe worries about possible contagion across the economy. With markets in Hong Kong closed for a holiday today, no chance for Evergrande investors to respond to today's news. Remember, Evergrande's shares listed there fell by 0.4% yesterday, and they are down by about 84% since the start of the year. But those keen to buy into Evergrande are looking at Frankfurt, where its shares are jumping. Now it's up by more than 30%. Key European indices are also pushing ahead, even as investors await a decision by the US Fed on monetary policy later today.